Hey YouTube, so we are on the 25th day of Veda, and today I was on a group on Facebook. I believe it's a Nerdfighter group, and someone posted a picture of baby Moana and how she was shirtless and said their mom had an issue with it and they were wondering what people thought. And I read the answers, and a lot of them were very intensely negative towards this woman no one had ever met. Saying she was sexualizing the kid and this and that, and I posted something saying, oh, if I had designed her, I probably would have put a little shirt on her. And there was a comment, and so why that's not Polynesian culture, X, Y, and Z, all that stuff. And I said, well, in children's media, sometimes we alter some cultural stuff for the sake of modesty. And I got a comment that was basically like, well, why does modesty matter? And a lot of likes on that person's comment. And I mean, I haven't been ruminating on this long enough to fully develop my thoughts and feelings towards this. If I can find it, I'll put a link in the com down the doobly-doo of this really cool video that talked about swimsuits and what happens to people. A man's mind and things like this, and how it impacts the woman negatively if modesty's not really being held up on her account. But I think having modesty with children is beneficial, even, if a toddler doesn't have breasts, even if some doesn't have the bits that they're really covering, or is a sex object for the most part. There are very disturbed people out there, but I think it's a good teaching tool that we start teaching modesty when you're young. At my church, when we do a water thing, and I'm the one in charge of it, I write flat out, no two pieces. Because I think teaching modesty is important. And I think we should start when you're younger. Moana is a fictional character, so this and that. But I think being modest, and this is not just a woman thing, I mean, there's different levels of modesty, but I think being modest for men and women is res it's about respect, and it's about respecting your self, if you're religious, but respecting God. It's about respecting the other people around you. If I'm walking around shirtless, it's not super beneficial for good Christian guys. And it's about just holding on to that concept of respect. So, if I am covering myself and not making all those parts of myself the focus, I'm showing I'm more than just that. And again, this is not just women. I mean, a woman's body is different than a man's body, so there are different aspects to cover, but I don't think a man should be walking around without a t-shirt outside of a swimming pool or the beach. It actually really disappoints me to see like high schools having no problem with guys running and next to nothing. Like, that to me is really not acceptable and super against dress code anyways. But no, if you're a guy, you should be wearing a shirt and some form of pants. Most of the time, if you're a girl, you should be wearing top and pants or skirt or a dress that doesn't show all your body parts. I mean, I'm not saying there's an easy delineation, and some different cultures have different concepts and things of that nature, but it's all about respect, and I think that's what modesty teaches. So, like I said, my thoughts are all over the place because I just read this not that long ago, and maybe I'll do a new video soon, but I'm gonna try to find that video that looks really scientifically at some of the benefits of modesty, and I'll put that down in the description area. Okay, I will see you guys tomorrow. God bless. Bye.